Hello and welcome to Rinku's Rasoi, where I'm sharing my cooking experience and cooking recipes with you guys. So when I have uploaded my last video about my travel preparation, I promised to share some recipes with you guys, and I got a lot of requests and comments about the recipes. So today I'm going to share instant dal mix recipe, and that is Gujarati dal. So as I show you in that video, I got three packages from the outside. One of these oat mix, the other one is tomato soup, and one more I had like misal rasa, which I already use it, so I don't have it right now. So let me tell you about it. Instant oat mix, it says masala oats with veggie twist. So I made this one time, and telling you frankly, I did not like the taste. Usually I make this oat mix at home and it tastes much better than this recipe, but I was in rush, so I just buy this packet, and then I check the ingredients and it has lots of chemicals and lots of preservative in it, so definitely it's not healthy. But if you are in rush and you don't have any time to make stuff at home, you can definitely use it, but you can make much better taste and healthier at home. I just keep it to show you guys, and I just use one time, and frankly speaking, I'm not going to use it again. So I did not like the taste for this one. So now about the tomato soup. We use 2 packets of tomato soup, and 2 packets are like more than enough for 8 people. So I think I would use for 8 people, I would use like 1.5 packet, and it tastes good, and the consistency of soup was really good too. But again, it has lots of chemicals, so health wise I would not recommend, but the taste wise it was good. And the other one was misal rasa. So we made that misal at camping, and we use with bun, and it tastes really good. It says spice level 3, and it was really spicy. So whoever like the spicy food, they can try this. Now coming up to the homemade recipe. So I'm going to share this recipe. This is instant Gujarati dal mix, and we made this 2 times, one at the camp and one after coming home. It tastes really amazing. Yeah, it definitely tastes a little bit different than the one you boil the dal at home and do all the spices and masala, but this really tastes amazing. So let's start making this dal mix. So first of all, I'm taking a damp cloth. I'm just showing you how to prepare the dal. I already prepared it, but I'm going to show you the method how to prepare it. Take a damp cloth, make sure it doesn't have to be very wet, it has to be damp. And then I'm taking 1/2 cup of tuvar dal, and then rub your dal, rub it between the cloth. Just rub it like this to remove all the impurities and all the debris from the tuvar dal. And when you are purchasing dal, make sure it doesn't cover with any oil, it has to be dry dal. So just dry dal and just rub it with the damp cloth. You can just do like this and rub it. This will remove the debris from the dal. You have to do it 3-4 times, just like this. So this will clean your dal. Make sure do not wash the dal. So once you are done, so because of the towel was damp, your dal will be little bit moist. So you can just take this into the plate. Then you can let it dry under the sun, or you can just microwave for 2 minutes. So I have already cleaned my dal and I have microwaved it for 2 minutes. So now I'm going to prepare my dal mixture. So now I'll transfer my dal into the blender. And cover the lid. And then I'm going to make fine powder out of it. So here my dal powder is ready. Make sure to make a very fine powder. Now I'm going to prepare the tempering. So for the tempering, I'm taking 1 tablespoon of oil. So whenever you are making this mixture to store for longer time, always take little bit more oil than required, because oil will work as a preservative. So let the oil heat up little bit, and in this oil I'm going to add 1 teaspoon of mustard seeds and let it pop. When the mustard seed starts to splutter, I'm going to add 1/4 teaspoon of hing, asafoetida. Seven to eight black pepper, this is whole black pepper, 2 cloves, 1 small cinnamon sticks, 1 red chili, I just cut the chilies into the small pieces, and then I'm going to add my dal powder in it and then cook it. And now cook for 2 to 3 minutes until all the tempering will coat the dal. So cook for 2 to 3 minutes on slow temperature. One more tip for the instant mixes. Whenever you are making instant mixes, make sure to cook everything on very slow temperature. That way you will remove the moisture very nice and it will stay fresh for longer period of the time. So roast the dal on slow temperature for 2 to 3 minutes. After like 1 to 2 minutes, you will have the aroma of the dal. And whenever you are cooking, make sure to stir continuously. So now the dal is nicely roasted. I just switch off the flame. I'm going to transfer this into the bowl and I'm going to let it cool down for at least half an hour. So here I transferred my dal into the bowl and I'm going to wait for half an hour. So it's been half an hour and this is cooled down completely. Now I'm going to add rest of the masala in it. So I'm adding 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric powder, 1/4 teaspoon of garam masala, 1 teaspoon of cumin and coriander powder, 2 teaspoon of salt. I'm using pink salt. If you want, you can use regular salt. So 2 teaspoon of salt, 2 teaspoon of red chili powder, 1 teaspoon of pickle masala. This is optional, but I like to add pickle masala in the dal, so that's why I'm adding pickle masala. Then this is curry leaves. I just dry this curry leaves into the microwave. I just put it in the microwave for 30 seconds and I have like nice dry curry leaves. So I'm just going to add curry leaves in it. 3 to 4 tablespoons of cilantro. This is dhania. I washed the dhania and then let it dry on paper towel. Then cut it and put it on the paper towel and microwave it for 3 minutes. And check every 30 seconds. So I'm going to add that dhania in it. 2 pieces of dry mango. This is amchur. This is homemade amchur. You can check my video how to make amchur at home. This one I'm adding for the sour taste. So I use amchur for the dal, but if you are using kokum, you can also use kokum in this. Then 1 piece of dry date. This is total optional, but I like to add dry date in the dal. So I just cut into small pieces and I'm adding dry date in it. This will give your dal a very nice consistency. And now last but not least, I'm going to add 3 teaspoons of sugar. I'm not going to add any jaggery in it. So for sweet taste, I'm adding sugar in this dal. So add 3 teaspoons of sugar. If you like little bit sweet dal, you can add little bit more. So all the spices you can adjust according to your taste. Now mix everything together. So this one I took 1/2 cup of dal. So this is good for family of 4. So now your dal mixture is ready. Now you can store this into the Ziploc bag and you can store it outside for at least a month. And if you are storing it in the refrigerator, it will stay fresh for at least 4 to 5 months. So I am using 1 cup of this dal mixture and 3.5 cup of water. And now let it cook. I'm just going to stir one time. So here it's been 7 minutes and my dal is ready. As you can see, it's nice and thick dal. So consistency of water you can adjust according to your taste. So enjoy this tasty and flavorful dal instant mix. So as you can see, the healthier way and tastier way of making this dal mix. So try this at your home and take this with you when you are traveling. Even though you can make this at home and you can use it when you have guests at home or sometimes you are lazy to cook, you can use this dal mix. So I hope you like this recipe. I'll see you with the next episode of Rinku's Rasoi. Till then, happy cooking!